we stabilize what people are saying in the morning, the Togo and others who are presenting the manifesto, control inflation and stabilize the economy. Now, because of the peace, you get some entrepreneurs who now use the Uganda market now. These 46 million Ugandans are a resource in themselves. Somebody imports textiles and bags from China. Others import carpets, others import human hair. I think that human hair is of some dead people who died or something. They import all this. Now, the way they do that, so it's a resource. The market of Uganda is giving money to this importer. Of course, the disadvantage is that he's taking it to China. But he ends up with a lot of local shillings. Local shillings from where? From us. Now, if he's clever and disciplined like Kiggundu, after he has accumulated a lot of those local shillings, and that's what this is what I've been telling Kasita, you know the other Kasita group? Those are people who specialize on Oksaka. You know Oksaka, those who speak the Bantu dialects. Oksaka. When you don't grow your own food, you buy food from others. So, these people import. And in the course of importing, they accumulate a lot of money from us, which then they use to buy our dollars, which we have got from coffee, and take it to China. But those who are clever like Kiggundu say that now that I have sucked quite a lot of shillings from these people, and I am disciplined, I'm not a drunkard, I don't go to the bar to squander the money there, I don't go to for holidays abroad to squander the money there, let me now go into, I think he first went into real estate. He first went into real estate, building buildings now. Then from there now, and when he came to see me in Waikitura, I told him, I said, you are partially a minusi. You are partially a sucker, because you are sucking money from us and taking it to China. Now we go into value addition. That's how he started now looking at this agro processing. So I'm very glad. I wish all the others, these Kasitas, could do the same. But his contribution is, first of all, the spectacles to see an opportunity. He saw an opportunity that there was a need of bags and of textiles. Then he started importing them. Then he got money. Now, instead of squandering the money, he now directed it into real estate, now eventually into manufacturing. That's how some of the other people have started. Like this man called Dangote, the Nigerian. He started by importing cement, because I think in Nigeria they didn't have their own factories of cement. And he was importing cement from outside. And because of that, he got a lot of local money. And that's how he started building his industries. Even when I went to South Korea, I think this company, what is their company called? The one of electronics. That one there. I was told that its founder in 1931 was importing textiles. And from importing textiles, that's how he went into all, into the radios, into the what, eventually now, into the computers. So really, I'm very happy with some of these disciplined and entrepreneurial young people. So young, because Kiggundu is like 30 what? 37, is now an old man of 37. But when you started, he was much younger. So that shows you that Uganda has the opportunities. Because he's using our purchasing power, the purchasing power of Ugandans. That young man has used our pockets to concentrate money and do business. And we congratulate him for that. And not squandered it, not because if you had gone to nightclubs abroad to for holidays outside, he would have earned the money, but squandered it. But for him, he didn't.